Shalom, shalom to all of you who are listening to me this morning. My name is Chris Nkumana. I'm the host of the Kanguka broadcast. Today is Monday, and I would like to remind our new listeners that Kanguka is a Kirundi word, the language of Burundi, and it means wake up. The broadcast is available every day at 4 a.m. If you don't already have the Kanguka mobile app, you can download it from Play Store or App Store. Just type Kanguka. That's K-A-N-G-U-K-A. I would like to send my greetings to all the people who remember to pray for the Kanguka team. May I am bless you. I always give thanks to God for all the people who pray for us and for those who support us. When you pray for the Kanguka team, you should also remember to pray for the partners of Kanguka. There are many people who make a lot of sacrifices in order to support this ministry. It's thanks to our partners that the ministry is growing, the team is growing, the gospel is preached, people are getting saved, healed, transformed, and delivered. All of this happens because I am laid on the hearts of some people to support this work financially. Our partners also need your prayers every day. Please pray for them so that I am can continue to enable them to support his work. Let me tell you that whether you pray for us or you support us financially, we share the same reward in heaven for the wonderful things that are happening through this ministry. May all the glory be to I am. For those who aren't familiar with the name I am, is the name of God revealed by God himself as recorded in Exodus chapter 3 verse 14. As usual on Mondays, in this first part of the broadcast, I talk about the guiding principles of Kanguka. The first principle is to accept the will of God even if it's different from our own will. The second is to pray every day. And the third is forbidden to complain. Instead, we must give thanks in everything. Today I'm going to talk about the third principle, is forbidden to complain. Instead, we must give thanks in everything. People always find it hard to not complain when they are going through hard times. When you have problems, you often start saying bad words. This can easily happen in your home when your children are giving you a hard time, or when you face a difficult time at work or anywhere else. So you start speaking words that are driven by anger. Let me tell you that we need to be very careful with the words we speak, because they have an impact. They trigger something in the spiritual world. You should never let anger control you. Instead, you should have faith. You should change the way you see things. You need to believe that there is a God in heaven who sees us. I like to give the example of how the children of Israel kept complaining when they were in the desert after they left Egypt. They complained against Moses and against God many times, saying, "Why did you bring us into this desert? It would have been better if we died in Egypt. There at least we would have graves." They also complained about the manna that God gave them every day, and they said that they were better off as slaves in Egypt because they had better food. Please read Numbers chapter 14 verse 27 to 30. You will see that God was very patient with the children of Israel for a long time. He was patient with them every time they complained and they spoke negative words in despair. But in verse 27, God reached a point where he said, "How long shall I bear with this evil congregation who complain against me?" In verse 28 and 29, God said that he will do to them exactly as they have spoken. They had said that they would rather die in Egypt or in the desert than go into the promised land. So God said that he will do to them exactly as they have spoken and let them die in the desert. But he didn't do it right away. He was patient with them again. He gave them more time to repent and to change their attitude and stop complaining. Maybe you're complaining because you're going through hard times. You see no change in your situation, so you complain in order to let out some of your frustration. God may be silent, but he doesn't mean that he agrees with you. He's giving you an opportunity to change your attitude. He's giving you more time so you can change your speech and you can start having faith. Remember that a person who complains is a person who has already lost faith. So in this story, in the book of Numbers, God did to the children of Israel exactly as they had spoken, and he let them die in the desert, as you can see in verse 29. Every person who was 20 years or older died in the desert just as they had spoken. So let's change our attitude and let's stop speaking negative words. Don't say bad things to your children or your spouse because you're angry at them. Change the words that are coming out of your mouth. Have faith and put your trust in God. You need to stop complaining, because when you complain, you're opening a door that Satan will use to come into your life. So change the way you speak, put your eyes on I Am, and wait patiently for His perfect timing. Now in the teaching portion of the broadcast, the last book of the Bible we studied is the book of Romans in the New Testament. So now we're going back to the Old Testament, and we're going to start studying the book of Judges. It's a book that many people don't understand very well. Our goal is to understand how those Old Testament stories are relevant to us today in the New Covenant. We study those books so we can understand what the Holy Spirit is saying to us today. When you read those Old Testament stories, you may wrongly think that they were only relevant in the Old Covenant. But if you pray and you ask the Holy Spirit for guidance, He will enable you to understand how those stories are still relevant to us today in the New Covenant. Before I start reading the Bible, I always ask the Holy Spirit to enable me to understand how the things I'm going to read are relevant to me today. As you can tell from the name of the book of Judges talks about the judges that God raised up to deliver the children of Israel. The book contains 21 chapters. I can't cover every verse of every chapter. That's why I ask you to read chapters in advance, and I talk about the key verses. It's easier for you to understand when I talk about chapters that you've already read, because I can't go into the details. So in preparation for tomorrow, please read chapter 1 and chapter 2 at the end of this broadcast. As I told you earlier, the book of Judges talks about the 12 judges that God appointed over Israel for a period of time. I want to clarify that the judges we are going to see in this book are very different from the judges we have in our society today. When you hear about a judge, you may think about a public official who's appointed to make rulings in a court of a law. But this isn't the type of judge this book is talking about. This book isn't talking about the judges in the court of a law. It's talking about the people who were used by God in order to deliver the children of Israel. When Israel was suffering at the hand of another nation, God would raise up a person called a judge, and He will use that person to deliver His people. He will give the judge wisdom and the strategy for defeating the enemy. The people would listen to them, and they would deliver the children of Israel from their enemies. They didn't have any special powers on their own, but the grace of God was upon them, and it gave them the power to do what God wanted them to do. So these weren't people appointed in a court of a law. Their job wasn't to oversee court cases. You need to understand that they were the people who led the children of Israel every time they were attacked by another nation. As I mentioned earlier, this book talks about 12 different judges, and they led Israel for more than 300 years. It means that during all that time, Israel didn't have a king. I want you to understand that since the time of Moses and Joshua, and during the time of the judges, God Himself would always appoint someone who would lead His people. He would empower and use that person in order to deliver Israel from its enemies. We see later in 1 Samuel chapter 8 that at some point the children of Israel demanded a king because they wanted to be ruled by a king like the other nations. But God didn't want them to have a king. It wasn't plan of His plans for Israel. God wanted them to be led by judges who were regular people who didn't live in palaces and who were appointed by Him, meaning that God Himself was leading Israel. We see later on that the children of Israel insisted on getting a king so they can be like the other nations, but God didn't want anyone else to receive the honor that should have been His alone. We see in this book that these judges were regular people. They didn't have any special honor. They couldn't oppress their people. Instead of oppressing them, they helped the children of Israel. So, as I told you earlier, they were judges of Israel for more than 300 years, and we're going to look at the lives of the different judges who led the children of Israel during that period. Today was just an introduction, so please read chapter 1 and 2 in preparation for tomorrow. But there is already one thing I want you to know about this book. From the beginning to the end of this book, we see the same scenario repeated over and over again. The children of Israel get to a point where they turn their back on God and they start worshipping idols. Then God gets angry at them and he allows another nation to attack them and to oppress them. Because of their suffering, the children of Israel turn their back to God and they cry out to him for help. God hears their cries and he sends a judge to deliver them. And the same cycle starts again. God willing, we'll continue tomorrow. Please read chapter 1 and 2. May I am bless you. Have a wonderful day. If you want to repent or you're transformed by these teachings, you can contact us by sharing your testimony in order to edify other listeners by contacting us on +256 781 377 337.